same system of worship, same system of study. Like, I mean, even, you know, the books, talking about the books. The Vaishnavas have a problem, they have too many books. You can never read them all. You have guys like Atulananda Chai who writes all day. Who's gonna read that, you know? There is so much literature. I suffer from it because I got libraries stuck with books which I never read. And I was dreaming of the day when I would be very peaceful. I can read all my books, and then somebody comes into my room and says, Gurudeva, what? My wife wants to leave me. Oh my God, call her in. Hey, don't you think you can tolerate this stupid guy a little bit more long? I mean, reading books, you know, talking of reading books, you know, is so much trouble is going on in this world. And then all this, like when we looked at the cleaning of Varshana yesterday, that was a historic event. We removed 50 years of garbage from one little place, you know, just to show that there was earth under. But it was really unique. And in a way, in the history of the cleaning, they're probably still going to talk a few years about this white madman who came to remove all this garbage from there, which they had thrown for 50 years. It's like something, whoever saw it at least. Anyhow, Prabhupada is giving us these jobs. Jobs after jobs after jobs, I tell you. Prabhupada is the number one job giver. He gives us so much to do. And like I say, now in the kirtan movement, they have to do yoga with kirtan. Already it's understood that yoga without kirtan is no real yoga. And yoga without surrender is also not real yoga. But they have not really come to that point yet, because that's going to be a real shocking experience. You mean yoga means you have to surrender? Really? I thought yoga was just twisting your body a little bit. So all these plans Krishna has made, and the Srimad Bhagavatam and everything, Prabhupada has made so wonderful plans. And these plans started thousands of years ago. Tirupati is worshipped for thousands of years. Even in the Vedas, it's mentioned, the temple of Jagannath and the temple of Tirupati. Other temples not. Other temples, they have only 1,000 years. One time, I was with, 1,000 years from, in the USA, any building which is older than 100 years, they say, oh, national monument. I was once with the Ramanuja Jir, who came to the Vishva Vaishnava Rajshava meeting in Mayapur. And he was a very nice man, very nice. I said, Maharaj, how are you? I said, okay. He says, he said, oh, you're from the Vinda Mission, okay. I said, you have temples outside of India? I said, yes, we have a few temples. They said, how old are they? I said, well, some of them are 5 years, 10 years, 20 years. Even some temples have only 35 years. Oh, he said, very interesting. And I said, hey, Maharaj, how old are your temples? Oh, I said, I'm now taking care of 60 temples. The youngest of them is 700 years old. Okay. So, it means all these old stone relics, these unbelievable places, and he was managing it with the Lodis and Brahmacharis and everything. So, it's there's a lot of thing going on. There's a lot of fashion going on also. Like now the fashion is of that the guru has to have a guru, little gurukul schools, like 100 or so young boys who are studying, and they come and sing and dance. I don't have that gurukul group. I have instead the beautiful ladies from South America group. They come and they show, oh, they are all bhaktas. They are chanting Hare Krishna and they are doing Brahma. Huh? People really get, Krishna has so many ways to promote. To promote himself is unbelievable. So I wanted to share with you this importance of Srimad Bhagavatam and of who is Prabhupada and what did he establish, because Prabhupada established a holy place in every town and village in the world. Prabhupada told us to make rasa yatras everywhere. He told us to distribute prasadam everywhere. And you know, still we are little pipsqueaks. We know nothing. That's what I say, the old worship of the Ramanuja Sampradaya, the Madhvacharya Sampradaya. That is such an old worship. And it's not because of the value. The value is really nothing. The thing is, they have the best thing for Krishna. That is the concept. They have such expensive outfit for the deities because this is the teaching. Krishna is God, and for God you have to give everything. So instead of hanging necklace of jewels around your neck, you hang and you make everything original for Krishna. And that's why Krishna has the best diamonds, the best rubies, the best everything, just for dressing. This is his dress. Don't get envious. Huh? Rather give another jewel. So this is like is an amazing thing. It's actually a phenomenon. By the way, if you don't have the jewels on the deities, where are you going to have them? In some safe or in some rich man's house, hidden away under the floor? Who and when and where are going to have all these diamonds and all these things? Well, the best thing there with Krishna. Then they can be safe and we can show Krishna. I mean, look, in this temple in South India, Trivandrum, they opened the wall, which was kind of hidden, and the temple declared bankruptcy because of lack of revenue. So the people who came to establish some terms, they saw that there was this wall which could be a door. So they were taking the inventory of the temple to see how much money the government has to give to maintain it. They opened this thing and 5 rooms came out. And in those 4 rooms, they found 20 billions of dollars in valuables, just metal value, without considering the antiquity. 20 billions of dollars of gold and jewels and everything. And there was one more room there, and that was not opened because there was some spell or some curse. Said if this room is going to open, then everything will be spoiled. So the king said, we will not open this. Now this happened 15 years ago when they found this treasure, the greatest treasure in the world, in a temple. And then they started fighting, who is now the owner? Finally the court says, well, the royal family has to be the owner because they're the owner of the temple. So in this way, oh, Krishna, 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 oh, Krishna, you're so wonderful. You have so incredible things we cannot understand. We cannot understand why you are so worshipped with so much opulence, with so many great scholars and writing books about you all the time. We don't know why you have captured everybody's heart and then you make them go to Vrindavan and roll in the dust and say, Jai Radhe Radhe Radhe. I mean, Vrindavan Chandra told me he made Dandavat Parikrama in Vrindavan. You know why? He said, I wanted to know what it's like. Okay, that's also a reason to do parikrama. So today we could just gonna do a small little morning of the Radha Gopinath. I was going to take you to the school, but we are already in Chota Diwali, so no children go to school in these days. So we will do this. Now, after we go for the Gopinath, we will all go to Radha Govindaji and go into the Yoga Maya cave, where Radha Govindaji was kept for thousands of years. That place, which is a secret cave now, you can go inside if you offer some Lakshmi to the pujari. They let you get in there. You have to go outside. So we will do that in this morning after visit to Radha Gopinath. So first Radha Gopinath and cleaning the gardens also. That's part. But this is a 20-minute job with so many hands because it's already clean. Our cleaners are cleaning it, but it's always good in Kartik to put like one last hand there so that everybody will see they're looking after it nicely. And this is our special, like I told you this after Mangal Arati, this temple or the Radha Gopinath area has been like a love project of the Vrinda Mission. We have practically restored those gardens from nothing, from a big pile of rubble to the one of the most beautiful temples in Vrindavan. Now, still we have to do some more things, but who knows? We're waiting for the government to fix the old shrine because they didn't let us do that. Let's see what comes next. Thank you. Let's have some kirtan for the Lord.
Yeah.
And yes, commentaries, please.
Today we have to distribute the names for the 21st
day. Brothers? Ah, yes, let me explain that. We are all brothers and sisters. And as brothers and sisters, we want to do the Rajput. What's it called?
Bandaraksha.
And it has two names. Rajdut or Rasi. Purumara,
tomorrow is in Mungir, the Diwali party, and the other tomorrow is in Vedasun.
And what? Yes, that's separate.
So,
now we are talking about the brothers and sisters. So everybody's going to get a name, so he can symbolically give a nice gift to his brother and sisters. We do that. Actually, you know, this means that each brother and sister you have, it means everyone, and these are our brothers and sisters, they should get gifts from us. No, that's what, that gift symbolic, prasada, is like, it's mentioned in Datati Prati Grinati Guyamakyati Prichati Utibochayate Chavasat Vidipridalakshana. There's six types of loving exchanges, but specifically the brothers and sisters, especially the older brothers and the younger sisters, and so there has to be a big spirit of generosity, of protection given. And so we symbolically that we, you just pick a name. Oh, this is my brother, for me to give a gift to. So you can think about it. This is like a very, we have done that here every year. It's a very beautiful ceremony, and we are happy to share this with you this year. Different things we do in different years, but this is one thing. Now, I want you to write one paper, minimum 3 pages. In that page, in those 3 pages, you have to write, what did you learn in this Kartik? What has been the most important thing? What is it what you want to take home from this Kartik? This I want everybody to write for the end of the Kartik. You have a few days time to write it, but this, to really put your heart into that paper. What has been Radharani's importance to you and the Srimad Bhagavatam and all these things. And today you will get a name, so that you can buy the gift which is going to be gifted in? Or in our festival of our Diwali festival. So you better get it quickly so that you can still buy some gift. Buy some useful thing. Yes, Manta.
Could you repeat the 3 questions? How you learn Kartik? What else?
What have you learned in Kartik? What meaning this has for you, and what you like to take home from this Kartik to your respective place. Or you can write anything else you want to write. But at least 3 pages, no more than 5. No books. Writing is important. People don't write nowadays. If you don't write things down, you just forget them. That's why you are very intelligent to write everything in your book. Very important. Any other question? Yoga Shakti is going to leave us to. Because she has a little girl who's crying for mommy, come back. And a big girl who's crying, I want to go back to Vrindavan. So she has some. One was over here, one was there. Right. Yes, anybody has a birthday today?
When are we gonna do Govardhan?
It will be done. We have to see where to fit it in. These days is too much rush there. And tough for us. But we will do it. Oh, this evening today, I think we're gonna be back on the Yamuna. Because there's nothing so beautiful as the nights in the Yamuna. I could go there every night, but I didn't see the paper. I think it says Yamuna. See, evening farewell ceremony at Yamuna River. So we can still, some people have not brought their picture last time, but the main thing of our Yamuna tonight will be our family celebration. You may be requested to speak something tonight at the Yamuna. and the ones who make the candles in the make a lotus in the center with a Jai Radhe. Gurudeva, any commentary? Any more questions?
Hoy también está cumpliendo años Maharati.
Maharati? So that's why he's sleeping?
Siddhanta? Ekanet? He's asking you if you can connect with him. Do you have some
problem by phone?
Maharati!
Maybe I can use your phone.
Yes, and yesterday Maharaji did the big Priya Kunda job. ¿Tú alguna reacción de la piel al agua? Gayatri also not? Pero yo en el Priyakunda con mi cuerpo se. Pero el agua en Priyakunda era tan lindo, pero algo se me revuelve. Any other question, please? Suggestion, please? Nitai? Camilo, you okay? So then let's sing for our Lord some songs.